don't know what size of the organizations are here. I know there's some small organizations and there's some large organizations. The bigger the organization, the bigger every department, the bigger the sales department, marketing, HR. And so different people on the teams have different functions. And it's your job to figure out, it's really the company's job, but it's your job to figure out who does what and who you can talk to. So there's usually an HR team, and maybe an HR administrator, or a coordinator, or a manager, internal recruiters, or external recruiters, training and development, which often in large organizations, these two are completely separate from HR, or they are in different silos, which to me doesn't make sense because it should all be, everybody should be working together. But the bigger you get, you have to kind of put people into different departments and different roles. And then the executive and leadership team is definitely human resources. They're not filing papers, they're not enrolling people in benefits, they're not writing up disciplinary action forms, although they should be. But they are 100% human resources, just like they are marketing, just like they are business development. I think one of the few things they are not is IT. I leave them to the side there. And then the management team. So anybody in here who is a manager, a supervisor, a line supervisor, any type, you are now human resources. Welcome to the HR team. So I always tell people when I'm in an organization and somebody gets promoted, I'm like, welcome to the HR team. Welcome to the marketing team. Welcome to the sales team. Welcome to the business development team. Did you really think you were going to get that project done now? Because that kind of goes to the wayside if somebody else needs to do it, because now you're dealing with higher level items. And again, any kind of supervisor responsibility. So I'm going to get my HR person, and I call myself the HR lady, and I'm not the typical HR lady. And I always get, on like Twitter, on these like groups and everything, HR people get offended occasionally. Stop calling human capital. Is it human capital? I think it is. You guys are entitled to your opinion, but I think it is. This is the definition of capital. Wealth is a form of money or assets taken as a sign of the financial strength of an individual, organization, or nation, and assumed to be available for development or investment. I put things in red because I think that explains human capital, the people of the organization. Now, do you treat people like, there's this laptop? No, they have feelings, they have emotions, but they are an asset. And guess what? They're the most expensive asset in your organization. There is nothing more expensive than payroll. Trust me. There is the most expensive asset. And everything that you have to provide with them, the taxes, the insurance, is everything. Most expensive asset. They bring financial strength to your organization. Without them, you're really nothing. Unless you have some computer system that's whipping out some widgets, but what if that breaks? You need a person to come in and do it. So for most organizations, I'll go with 95% of organizations, without the people, you're nothing. And I think, I get so frustrated sometimes when I'm talking to employers that, a staff-level person who's not a manager has left the company. One leaves here, and they're like, I don't want to lose the manager. I'm okay with that. I'm like, well, without all those people, you don't need the manager. So you should be more worried about those people leaving than the manager. Now, you need the manager, too, because if the manager leaves, there's usually something wrong as well. So the biggest thing is financial strength, and this is it right here. This is why we're all here. Development or investment. We stress to our clients left and right, and this is why we're offering this at no charge thanks to the CFR, is if you don't develop and you don't invest in your people, they're going to leave. Worse, they're going to stay.